This is the Gospel Reflection for Friday of the sixth week of Easter. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John. Glory to you, O Lord. Jesus said to his disciples, "Amen, amen, I say to you, you will weep and mourn while the world rejoices. You will grieve, but your grief will become joy. When a woman is in labor, she is in anguish because her hour has arrived. But when she has given birth to a child, she no longer remembers the pain because of her joy that a child has been born into the world. So you also are now in anguish. But I will see you again, and your hearts will rejoice, and no one will take your joy away from you. On that day, you will not question me about anything. Amen, amen, I say to you, whatever you ask the Father in my name, he will give you." My sisters and brothers in Christ, the gospel, the good news of the Lord. Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. Although some places celebrated the Feast of the Ascension yesterday, in most parts of the U.S., in some parts of the world, we do so on Sunday. So our scripture reading today is Jesus anticipating his departure. Whether it's his departure at the crucifixion, because this is still from his Last Supper discourse, or his departure in his ascension, once he has been raised from the dead, we don't know for sure, but Jesus is saying, when his disciples know that he's gone from them, they will grieve. But he also has promised them in the last several Gospels that he will send them the Advocate, the Paraclete, the Holy Spirit. But I think that today's reading is especially wonderful because in it, John anticipates that those very apostles to whom Jesus is speaking will themselves be persecuted, will suffer, most will be put to death, except perhaps for the beloved disciple John, who is the evangelist here that wrote this Gospel. Jesus is telling them, when you are afraid, I'm telling you your fear and your anguish, either because of my departure or because of your danger once you are preaching my name to all the world, that will be taken by joy. It'll be overtaken by joy. You will find joy. And you will not ask Jesus any questions. Sometimes after a very difficult death, I tell the relatives of the person who has died, you're going to have the right to ask God questions. But in this gospel, Jesus says, the joy of being with the Lord will overcome our desire to ask any questions. All will be revealed. All will be clear, especially God's loving care and mercy for his people. May God bless you.